ask all the time, what is amblyopia? And amblyopia is basically when you have a child whose one eye does not see quite as well as the other. And then the second question becomes, so what can we do for it? And our first and best option for treating amblyopia is by doing patching.
The purpose of the patch is not to straighten the eyes, or not to prevent the child from needing glasses, but the purpose of the patch is to encourage visual development. And so the good eye is patched so that the other eye can be forced to see. And in being forced to see, that vision pathway from the eye all the way to the back of the brain, which is the part of the brain that does the seeing, is then allowed to develop. With both eyes open, the good eye takes over. And there's no reason for the brain to want to use an eye that doesn't see as well. How bad can vision get with amblyopia? It can be very, very severe. We are talking about, and I'll use the term legal blindness.
Child who has a misaligned eye, surgery can sometimes fix the misaligned eye, but it's not going to fix the vision in that eye. So patching, even if we realign the eye, patching will often still be necessary to improve the vision. So surgery is not going to fix that. People then also say to me, well, I'll just have my child get LASIK when they're older. LASIK's also not going to fix that. All LASIK is going to do is get you to your best vision that you would have had with glasses. But these children, even with glasses on, don't have good vision. So once again, we're back to patching as being our best option.
There is another alternative to wearing a patch, and that is using a drop called atropine. The drop, though, is not effective for more severe cases of amblyopia because the vision just doesn't get blurred enough with atropine.
We understand that this is not easy, especially if you have a child who really doesn't want to do this. Kids are stubborn. I have a stubborn child. I absolutely understand as a parent how difficult it is to have your child do something that they don't want to do.
We have that 5-year-old that is very willful and just does not want to wear that patch, and you want to give up. And you're done yelling.
Say, we're going to put a little timer on, and when that timer goes off, you are getting this treat. And maybe that first day, that timer's on for 15 minutes. Maybe it's not this, you know, full 2 hours or 4 hours or 6 hours or however long we eventually want you to get up to. So you're going to start off and put that patch on, put that timer on for just a limited amount of time. Your child did a great job. Say, that's so good. We're so proud of you. Take that patch off. Give them that prize. So just be consistent. If some days it's 15 minutes, it's 15 minutes. If other days they've forgotten about it, you can keep it on for 6 hours, keep it on for 6 hours. And that's really how you have to do things with these young kids.
Well, a different approach might be to take an activity that the child loves to do. Maybe there's a special iPad game that you let the child do on your device, or maybe there's a special TV show that the child loves to watch on a daily basis. Well, the rule of the house may be then, when the child does that activity, that's when the patch is on, and that's only when the child can do that activity. And that's the other thing, the child put a patch on, kind of zone out, or take a nap, is not patching. It's visual activity. So near activity, video games, television, reading a book, coloring, those are great tasks. Tie it into something that the child loves to do and make it the rule of the house. When you successfully treat amblyopia, you're giving that eye vision and that child vision for an entire lifetime.
We stand behind you. We are here for you. If you've got questions, you want to call us, if you just need that motivation to keep going, your child needs, you need some tips on how to motivate your child, we're here. We're happy to answer any sort of questions and be that motivating factor for you.